Hello, Redeemer's kids, family, friends. This is Miss Fran coming to you from the beautiful sanctuary of Redeemer Lutheran Church in Pittsburgh, North Carolina. I have on my coronavirus mask, and since I think I'm the only one here in the church today, I'm just going to slip it off. Okay? Oh, does that feel good? And I'm sure each of you have been wearing your mask, so you know exactly what I'm talking about. How good that feels to be able to have air on your face and breathe in fresh air that's not hot. Fogged up my glasses. Breathing, that's something that we do naturally. And your body just does that. That's the way God created these beautiful bodies that we have. The average person takes anywhere from 12 to 18 breaths a minute. Wow. If you take that for 24 hours, over 23,000 breaths in a day. When we run, we breathe a little harder and faster. But when we're sitting or just walking, we breathe normal pretty much. And they say that when we sleep, we even breathe softer and less. Breathing is something that we don't really control, but we can control. Let's just hold our breath for a count of 10. Count to three and hold your breath. One, two, three. Feels good to let it out. It's just a natural process that when God created our bodies that our brain says, okay, lungs, I need you to get some oxygen in here. So they inflate and then they deflate and the body absorbs what part of the oxygen. So it's a natural process. Our prayers are kind of like breathing. They're natural. We do them sometimes without thinking. But in the book of Thessalonians, in the first book of Thessalonians, the Apostle Paul writes in chapter 5 that God wants us, it's his will for us, to rejoice at all times, to pray without stopping, and to do this in the name of God for Jesus Christ. Does this mean that God wants you and I to walk around with our hands folded, our eyes closed, and our head bowed, praying all the time? I don't think so. I think that could be really dangerous. We could injure ourselves or someone else. If we were walking down the sidewalk and walked off the side, we could twist an ankle. If a bypasser is coming towards us, we could run into them. I don't believe he wants us to pray that way. I think, just like when we breathe, we don't really notice it. It just happens. We breathe because our bodies need it. We don't think about breathing. We don't say, okay, friend, it's time to take a breath. Your body just does it. I think this is the way God wants our prayer lives to be, our conversations with him. He wants us to know that he is always there for us and with us. All we have to do is call on him. He wants us to talk to him like a friend in conversation. It's like I'm having this conversation with you right now. You hear me. You see me. Well, he hears me. He sees me. He answers my prayers. So when you need to have a prayer or a conversation with God, you just need to have a place. It doesn't matter where. Anywhere, anytime, you can talk to God. Thank you, dear Father, for all the frontline warriors who are helping take care of us during this pandemic. And thank you for the many veterans who over the years have given their lives for the freedoms that we all enjoy.
Thank you for chocolate chip cookies and milk.
Thank you, God, for the blue skies, the white clouds, and the beautiful sunshine, and even the rain that comes and moistens the ground. Thank you also for all the beautiful flowers we get to plant and watch grow.
You see, God wants our prayers and conversations with him to be just like our breathing. We can breathe anywhere, anytime. We can breathe fast, we can breathe slow. Okay, we can pray anytime, any place. We can pray long prayers or short prayers. We just need to come to Him for conversation. Prayer is not limited to being in the church. It's not limited to morning, noon, and night. It can happen whenever, and it can be about whatever. So if you're happy, pray. If you're sad, pray. If you're thankful, pray. If you're worried, oh, by all means, double pray. Just come to God in conversation, being honest and truthful, like a friend. And he will be there for you. When I was with you last, I gave you a sign language message, and it was, I love you. Today I'm going to leave you with another one, and it's for somebody else loves you too, not just me. And you just start with your hand up about our eye level, folding the thumb, fingers pointed straight up, eyes are looking up, and you are saying, God loves you. Again. God loves you. But He also loves God loves me. And so until we meet again at Redeemer, and that will be soon, I just want you to always remember, Miss Fran, I love you.